I'm Dr. Ramona Lim. I work in the Lynch Syndrome Center as a gastroenterologist at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute and Brigham and Women's Hospital. Colonoscopies are so important in Lynch syndrome because if you have Lynch syndrome, you're at an increased risk of developing polyps or benign growths in the colon, which could lead to colon cancer. We recommend annual colonoscopy because colon polyps in Lynch syndrome can grow at a much more accelerated pace. And the pace from a polyp to a cancer is also rapidly accelerated. And colonoscopy is the most important preventative step we can take to find and detect polyps, remove them before they have the opportunity to turn into something more serious. A provider performs a colonoscopy with a thin, flexible tube with a light and a lens that's inserted into the rectum and advanced through the colon to look for these colon polyps or growths. And as we see a small growth, most of the time we're able to remove it right then and there. It is the one examination for colorectal cancer screening where we actually have the ability to prevent colon cancer from occurring. It's also important because early detection means that we can diagnose a colon cancer at an earlier, more treatable and curable stage. You should have instructions for the procedure sent in advance of what type of diet to consume before the procedure, what type of bowel prep or laxative that you will take to clean out the colon so that we get a good look. It's probably the single most important part of colonoscopy in order for us to be successful, to find polyps that could be very small, flat, and even subtle within the lining of the colon. It's critical that a thorough cleansing of the bowels or the large intestine or colon are performed prior to the examination. During the test, you actually have a needle placed into your vein to allow us to be able to give medications that make you sleepy, relaxed, not anxious, and forget about the examination. Not everyone falls asleep during a colonoscopy, but many people do have a nice nap during their procedure and don't remember anything about the examination. And it's important because this is a safe, critical, important examination to perform, and especially if you're going to do it annually, like with Lynch syndrome, we want to make sure that the experience is as positive as possible. You should not be worried if your colonoscopy shows a polyp. This is what we're looking for. We're trying to find polyps and remove them at that time so that we can prevent polyps from growing into cancer. Not all polyps are precancerous, but most commonly, adenomas are the type of polyps that lead to colorectal cancer, and those are the ones that we particularly focus on with Lynch syndrome, but any type of polyps we typically try to remove during the time of the colonoscopy. When colon polyps are removed, the small tissue is actually submitted to the pathology lab where another doctor, a pathologist, looks at the polyp tissue under the microscope and tells us what type of polyp it is and whether or not there's any concerning features that have made a progression closer to cancer. It's important for them to have that evaluation so that we have a better sense about what the type of follow-up ought to be after a colonoscopy is completed. Typically, it takes a week or two to get those results, and your endoscopist's office typically will reach out to you with results of the biopsies for recommendations on when the next colonoscopy ought to take place.